but for your understanding, so that you may know what is right, I do as you requested. I give your heart so wise an understanding that there has never been anyone like you up to now and after you. In the name of the Father, and the Son, of the Holy Spirit, amen. This dialogue between the Lord and Solomon in the first reading is truly very beautiful and describes to us once again in such beautiful language and tenderness the intimate relationship between a soul that loves God and God himself with that person. Here we see that Solomon, as a young man, being the successor of the kingdom of Israel that had been founded and was very powerful under his father David, asks the Lord for something unique. He didn't ask for to be a king with great power. He didn't ask the Lord to have great wealth and riches. He didn't even ask the Lord to be able to extend his kingdom with a very powerful and militant army. Rather, he asks the Lord for wisdom and understanding, to be able to guide his people in the right way, in the clear path of the Lord's commandments and righteousness. That's why the third reading of today, the gospel, talks about the righteous and the impious, those who are faithful and those who are wicked. In the world in which we're living, if there's anything we truly need, all of us as Christians and as Catholics, is that great gift of the Holy Spirit of wisdom, good counsel, and understanding. The world in which we live in, as we know so very well, is filled with so many contradictions. News forecasts, the interpretations of different events are totally contradictory. Where to turn to find the truth? Whom to speak with to understand the reality of what is happening around us? We've seen in the very case of our own economy in this country, to be honest with you, with all sincerity, I don't know what the debt ceiling means. Maybe I'm an idiot, but I really don't understand the whole thing. And it's in the context of all of these things of confusion, of contradiction, of different mindsets trying to win us over to follow a philosophy or way of life contrary to our gospel, that we must ask the Lord truly for wisdom, good counsel, and understanding, and the fortitude to follow through what God tells us. Many of our young people, if we go on the trains or we go visiting different parts of our city during the summer, we can see that so many of them are so profoundly and deeply disorientated. Putting emphasis on the superficial things of life and forgetting that what really matters ultimately in the life of a human being is one's relationship to God. When I was with some friends of mine with a family, we went to Rockaway just a few weeks ago, I couldn't fathom what I saw there. I found it to be shocking. So many people with so many different forms of tattoos. I had never seen that. And I was in a state of shock seeing all of that. Half of the bodies of those young men who did this were covered completely with tattoos. I've asked many people who have taken tattoos, actually, when they're much older, if they're happy with their decision, and they all conclude the same. They regret having made that decision when they were young. This is a very superficial example of the mass confusion, misunderstanding, and disorientation that many of our people are victims of. We're not blaming them, but we are trying to see how to help that they may make the right decisions for their life. Putting on a tattoo ultimately is against the fifth commandment, but it may not be a serious thing unless it's excessive. But what truly is painful and sad, that's an expression of a real lack of true judgment and real respect for oneself. And this is why it's important during this Mass and during this season of the summer to be able to ask the Lord where best to please Him and how best to honor Him. How best to be able to express our love for Him with the people with whom we deal. And once again, we return to the ongoing rhythm and the constant theme of Christian life. There is no better way of pleasing the Lord in the summer, in the winter, and throughout our life than to pray to Him often, as King Solomon did, to obey those Ten Commandments as the Lord requires that of us, and to truly be compassionate and charitable towards others. And in this season of the summer, we know that there are many people who are alone, who live in those rooms with no one to invite them to go out, with no one to call them. It would be a wonderful gesture of charity, even if we feel uncomfortable with the person because the person may be quote unquote boring, to make an act of charity. Invite one of those poor persons abandoned in their rooms with little fans or little air conditioners to go out with us, to invite them to a little cafe, to be able to make them feel good with themselves. Because the Lord says it continuously, those who feed the hungry, those who clothe the naked, those who visit the sick, and it's not just those who are sick physically, those who are sick in so many different forms of loneliness and unhappiness and abandonment, as so many thousands are in our city. Those who also go to the prisons, and compassion on those innumerable persons who are in Rikers, those will be the elected of the Lord. Those are the righteous of the Lord. May we be among them as we live our life of charity in a special way during the season of the summer, reaching out especially to those whom we know may be family members or friends or neighbors who are truly alone with no one willing or able to invite them to go out even for one afternoon. The Lord will be honored and pleased with us because we're willing to be charitable and thus be a faithful disciple of His holy gospel in our life. If it requires sacrifice from us, the Christian life to which we have been called by the very nature of our baptism requires sacrifice, discomfort, and at times inconvenience to our needs or our pleasure. Because above all else, to be a true Christian and disciple, we must be willing always to sacrifice for the good of the holy name of Jesus and for the well-being of our neighbor, and in that way have God's blessing in our life. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen.